Yellow. I'm gonna go ahead and start, you know, just playing, vibing, talking. I'm not gonna be, gonna try not to be too disruptive or anything, just cause it's nighttime, I have roommates. And I'm just gonna, you know, hang out. Morning, Shayna. Winter's just around the corner. We need to double check the heating system, turn off the valves, and check all the insulation in the house. You are so right. Oh, thank you so much. You know, I totally forgot to do that last winter. Didn't even realize that was something. That sound scared me. I was like, what event is happening that I was not forewarned of? Ooh, my amaranth. I forgot what that is. Should probably replant some of it. Let me check. Did I get a heating system for my cows yet or no? My cow yet or no? Like, need to make sure I did, because he won't be happy if he's not warm. I should probably actually pull up something where I can see my stream on my other thing, make sure it's all working right. I'm just gonna hope. Why is ads still playing? This is. Sorry about the ads. I'm just leaving them to run because I do not care very much. Sorry. But. I didn't download the music I wanted to play beforehand. So this is what we're doing now. I swear, ads are getting, like, longer and longer, though. Like, they definitely were not this long before, right? They weren't. This is like four in a row. It's insane. I'm not sure what amaranth does, but I'm hoping it's something like cool. Otherwise, I don't know what I'm doing. But then again, I never have known what I was doing, have I? I suppose not much will have changed. Did I not milk the cow? I could have sworn I milked the cow. Huh, that's weird. Guess I have to loop back and milk the cow again. I'm really gonna have to make sure I like clear this land over winter. There we go. Milk that cow. Milked it for all it's got. I need to check, make sure my video's working in a second. After I get this milk in so I don't forget. Okay, let's make sure my video is working right. Okay, looks like it is. That is good news. Because last time every time I've streamed before, there's been something, you know? There's always something. But if this is actually working, that'd be really, really nice. I really need to get on my mining over the winter, because I think for next spring I want to try to have an entire sprinkler, the entirety of my farm set up for sprinklers, not just my secondary field. I want to have enough to get my main field as well. Oh, that's the dream. So there's just nothing here to... It'd be really funny if that misclicked made it, and I had to walk all the way back to the well, and then go back over and hit to refill that bowl. Like, I'd be upset, but it'd be funny. Anyways, if anybody's in chat, you know, feel free to talk about how you're doing. I'm trying to keep an eye on it. Love to talk to you. I can tell you how my day's going. Pretty good. I'm reading The Martian by H.G. Wells for a class. Technically, I'm supposed to have already, like, finished reading it and be starting on the report on it. But you know what they say? Better late than never. And I'll finish it tomorrow anyway, so it's not a big deal. I'm not, like, behind, you know? Some people be, like, behind, say they're, like, behind, and will be, like, they have 7 things due 3 days ago. I am not that type of behind. I am the, man, I should have this done in 2 days, and it's not quite done yet type of behind, you know? You know, the behind where that doesn't give you, like, massive panic. It just gives, like, a sense of disappointment. Anyway, but yeah, the War of Worlds by H.G. Wells is what I'm reading. I don't know if I said the right name earlier, because part of my brain keeps calling it The Martian, which is not the name of the book at all. It is about Martians, though. So, I'm going to give a plot synopsis because I'm bored. I'm thinking about doing a video about it, because I have to write this huge report anyway. And I figure, you know, if I have to be ready to talk for 15 minutes about it, I could just write a video script. It'd be that easy. It'd be so easy. I'd have already done all the work. Anyway, it starts off with this guy. He's a nerd. Our main character is an absolute nerd, and he looks through a telescope at space a lot. And they notice these blips that are basically like there's these blips from this surface of Mars, like some weird, like, they think it might be an astronomical event on Mars, or meteorological event on Mars or something, because this takes place in, like, it was written in, like, 1890, like, 6, so, like, they're working on old-timey logic at this point, so anything could be happening on Mars for all they know. And, basically, they notice this thing and are like, man, it's weird how that's happening, and they decide... there's something to this, and, like, they're, like, looking into it, but, like, they don't really get far looking into it before, basically, they start to notice more, like, the whatever it was that they saw on the surface of Mars is, like, approaching or something, and they're, like, man, that's weird, and before they really have time to do anything about it, this, like, cylinder-shaped, like, spacecraft hits the, planet, like, coincidentally really close to where this guy, main character guy, lives. And so then it's there for a while. People are, like, gawking, whatever. People don't really know what's going on. They don't know what it is. They're like, man, this is nuts. And then the cylinder opens and people start dying and a Martian crawls out. And no one really gets a good look at it because anyone who gets too close just gets eviscerated by this heat ray. And basically, it just murders anybody who gets too close or, like, poses a threat to the Martian. And then, it's starting to put something together in the pit. And the military's called, obviously, because people are getting murdered. Like, lots of people are dying. Like, this is not like people are dying. It's a, oh no, people are dying. And what's this over here? There was, like, a thing, I thought. Never mind. So, you know, people are getting eviscerated by the Martian's heat ray. and the military's called in, and they're, like, firing weapons at it, like, shooting at it and stuff. You know, after, like, doing, like, you know, normal bureaucracy things of standing around for a couple days, right? And then all of the soldiers who are there get murdered, and more soldiers are called in. And, like, there's a... And then, like, the main character's like, I live, like, 2 miles from here. I should get my wife away from this. This is, like, bad. This is not good. And so he gets his wife, and he rents a horse-drawn wagon. He is renting a horse because it is the 1890s. And he rents this horse-drawn carriage and loads up his wife and his valuable possessions and then drives to a town a little ways over. And this book takes place in England. And basically where the town is, London is one direction. And he goes the other direction with his wife, which turns out to be a good call later. So he takes his wife and gets her down away from everything. 10 out of 10. Thank you for doing that. You know, always gotta look out for the wife. And then what happens is, I bet I've scared anybody who was watching this off, haven't I? No? Are you here? Hey, if you're here, I hope you're enjoying my synopsis so far of War of Worlds. I'm not done with the book, though, so I am gonna leave you on a cliffhanger, so you might as well follow, and I'll tell the rest of the plot, like, past where I am after I finish reading it. Which I'll probably finish reading it tomorrow, and maybe stream tomorrow, maybe not. Maybe not till, like, Saturday. Anyway. So he takes his wife, and then, like, gets her settled in with, like, a cousin of his, right? That way she'll be safe. And then he goes back, because he has to return the horse, because he rented the horse, because it's the 1890s. And he returns this horse. Well, he's going to return the horse. He doesn't actually make it back. He's going to return the horse. And a giant metal, like, machine creature thing. He's, like, super confused by it because he has no, like, frame of reference for what this thing is. But it's revealed later to be a machine made by the Martians. And he's, like, going to, like, look at this thing. And, why'd I say that? That's not what happens at all. He's going back to return the horse, and this giant metal machine's in the way. And it's, like, sort of like the Hydra robots in, like, the Avengers shows. Where it's, like, this, like, metal head and then, like, a bunch of, like, big tentacles. And basically he... I wonder if Shane likes pomegranates. Sorry. So he sees it, and he's like, oh my gosh, this thing's in the path, it's gonna kill me. So he obviously dips. Wait, what's this? 1 week from today, Stardew Valley Fair. Oh man, I need some good stuff for this event. Okay. A week from today, so I have a couple of days to get some stuff for it. Fair starts at 9 a.m., Well, university display. I'm gonna pause the game and just pause my audio so I can finish explaining this a little bit, because I'm getting a little too turned around while I'm talking. So he sees it in his way, and he, like, violently turns the horse. He crashes this horse-drawn wagon. And this turns out to be good, because the Martian is, like, destroying things in its path, and he barely manages to escape from, like, being a coward. And I'm gonna try to keep playing, actually, while I talk, sorry. So he barely escapes, with his life, and he gets into town, and everything is, like, chaos, and it's only been, like, a day, but it has been a day, even though he went only, like, a little bit, but, you know, it's been a day, because it's the 1890s, so traveling takes a while, unless he goes by train, which he did not. So yeah, he gets back, things are in chaos. The guy he rented the horse from, never mentioned again, I assume fled or dead. The town is, like, burning, everybody is flipping out. For the record, when he realized, maybe I should get my wife and get out of Dodge, he never mentions it to anybody else, that, hey, maybe we shouldn't be here anymore. He just keeps that information right to himself. which is so funny. He's just like, oh man, I better take my wife and escape so that surely no foul fate shall befall us. But screw everybody else, I guess. Anyway, so the town's in chaos, and he meets up with this guy to figure out what had happened. It's a soldier guy, because more military people had arrived. And basically, the guy's like, yeah, it's all gone. Everything, they've murdered so many people. More military is being called in. Everybody needs to be evacuating, whatever. And they basically hide out in the guy's house for a little bit, waiting until, like, daytime, because it was, like, the middle of the night when he got back. And basically, I can't remember the exact series of events after this. He goes towards, he's trying to make it back to where he left his wife. But the place that he left his wife is, like, somehow not accessible anymore. At least not, like, pretty well. Especially since he did murder the horse. The horse is dead. So he has to, like, take a roundabout route. And at this point, there's, like, people. And so he gets to, like, another town over, because he's basically been told which direction to go by the soldier. He's traveling with the soldier for a bit. I'm pretty sure the soldier dies, though. I don't remember, which I probably should remember since I have to write a whole report on this book soon. Anyway, but the soldier's not mentioned again after a little bit, but they're basically, the soldier's like, yeah, we gotta go this way. This is where, you know, I have to go to try to meet up with my group, my, like, it was, like, battalion or something, I don't know. And they get to, like, another town, like, not too far away. Like, they walked there, like, in, like, a night. So, like, not super far. And there, people literally are not that close when, like, his town is, like, pretty much destroyed. People that close are not taking it seriously. They're, like, they think of the Martians as, like, kind of strongish humans instead of as this terrifying, destructive force. So they think that the military is going to stop the advancement before it reaches them. Newsflash, it does not. The Martians arrive right after our main character does and just start destroying everything. Everybody is getting murdered. People are burning alive because they're using this heat ray. Did I explain heat ray? So it's like some sort of like power bank attached to like focused with a mirror, and it just boils anything on impact, which is really bad for humans because we do not survive being boiled. But yeah, so the heat ray, and, you know, it's boiling people, destroying houses, and then, sorry, my brain's just, like, farting out there, it's destroying everything. People, literally, up until the moment the Martians were arriving, actually a couple moments after the Martians are arriving, people haven't realized the threat. Once they do, everyone is freaking out because they are all gonna die. And then most of them do die. They get murdered. Absolutely demolished. And basically the military's fighting back though, and for the first time, some damage is done to one of the Martians. They managed to take down one of the Martian things, but they've estimated there to be like 15 or 20 of the things. And in them destroying one, like, Martian robot, all of the military people who were there have been murdered. They are dead. They are gone. All of the gear that they had there was gone. Everything is bad. And this all kind of sucks because, like, man, you know, it took all of that just to take down one of them. And there's, like, a bunch more. And there's more on the way because there were, like, a lot of flashes back when that flashes thing I was mentioning at the beginning was. So with all those flashes, they know there's gonna be so many of these things, and it took all that just to kill one of them. So the main character's like, technically there is hope, but we are also so dead. But he has, like, this cursory amount of hope, which is more than, like, other characters he runs into have, which makes him sound more hopeful than he is, but he's just like, yeah, there is technically a chance we can survive. And it's like, man, this is the height of hope, apparently. Anyway, so he barely survives a massacre because he realizes that if he jumps into the water, the heat from the heat ray will be diffused and therefore be less deadly, which is super clever, except he does almost get boiled alive in, like soup. He gets souped, almost. He almost gets souped, but he's fine. He lives. He's badly burned, but he lives, which means he's fine. You know, the bar is on the floor right now. Anyway, so he's, like, traveling to try to get to somewhere safe after this, because obviously he can't stay there. The Martians are advancing towards London. Basically, London just gets eviscerated. We don't even need to think about that much. But we follow the main character's brother for a while, because the brother lives in London. So everything was going super bad starting, like, Friday, right? No one even realizes something is wrong until Monday morning. And by Monday morning, the Martians are almost to London. London's not in a good place. You could say it is, in fact, in a bad place. And so people are panicking, trying to evacuate London, right? Because it's like, oh no, death, destruction, and doom is coming our way. And people are getting trampled alive as people are trying to escape and stuff like that. You know, the normal stuff. Yeah, people are getting trampled. The brother realizes not to take the train because everybody's, like, trying to get into the trains and trampling each other, so he goes on foot instead, and he manages to make it down to a port town, and he gets onto a ship to escape. Along the way, he, like, runs into some girls, saves them from some vagabonds or whatever, who cares. He makes it to the port, and he gets onto a steamboat to escape to France, because France will be safe from the Martians. Surely they won't make it to France. So they're leaving for France, and a Martian machine is in the way of the ship. But there's this other ship. Like, this other ship that, like, manages just barely to, like, distract the Martian machine long enough that the steamboat full of refugees manages to escape. And then we cut back to the main character. He's traveling with this old guy he runs into, and he's the one who, like, gives, like, the technically there's hope even if we're kind of screwed talk. And then they travel for a bit. Again, main character, he is burned, a little boiled, he is delirious from lack of water, but he is alive. Still, this nerd. So he's traveling to try to, like, find, like, food and shelter and stuff, right? And they're in this house, like, going through it, and then one of the cylinders hits the house, and the main character still survives. So the cylinders that are, like, these are the spaceships. They're just always described as cylinders. So it hits the house and collapses most of it. But the room he happened to be in survived, but he's trapped inside. And he gets really good look at the Martian, and it spends, like, 4 pages describing these Martians. And they're basically a head with tentacles. And it's heavily implied the narrator believes that this form is caused them to not have morals. Because they are shaped this way, they do not have morals. And he also implies that he believes this is the natural evolution of intelligent beings. And then that's where I stopped reading. I think it does, actually. That's like, based on how it's described, but it's the top that opens, not, like, on the side. But yeah, it's like a cylinder spaceship. But it's probably just because it's the 1890s. They have no concept of what a spaceship would be. So this is him just thinking, man, if I were to go to space, how would I do it? And then he decided cylinders. Also, it's like something I didn't say. It's like implied at the beginning that the reason the Martians are coming is because they destroyed their own planet, which could be a great social commentary on humanity, or it could just be to show that the Martians suck. Anyway. But yeah, that is the story so far. When I say he spent 4 pages describing the Martians, I want you to know this is a book that is 130 pages long. It's not very long. He spent a significant portion of the book talking about how the Martians look. Oh, I did mention that the place he put his wife wasn't in the way of the Martians, right? Like, by sheer coincidence, the Martians went the other way. This guy is so lucky. Also, it's kind of weird that he kind of does describe it as that's where he put his wife. Like, the way it's described. It just, like, yeah, she's gonna still be there, is what he assumes. She's just gonna be there until he comes back for her. I don't know what the idea here is. But it was written in the 1890s, so maybe he just thinks women park themselves and wait? I don't know. Oh, the book is War of Worlds by H.G. Wells. It's like one of like a very old classic sci-fi book. I'm reading it for a report for class. I'm supposed to be already done and starting on the report, but I'm not quite done with the book yet. But I expect to finish it tomorrow. Oh, I keep pausing for a minute. I'm still seeing movement on the one I'm looking on another screen. I've been keeping an eye on it. But yeah, I do keep pausing to talk whenever I'm having trouble collecting my thoughts. Oh. Did not moving as... Sorry, I'm just still, like, worried about my stream stopping. But yeah. I don't know if he has a concept of a handbrake, though. Because cars haven't been invented yet. This whole thing takes, this whole thing was written before cars. It's so funny, all the like, oh yeah, because you didn't hear about the horse, did you? He rented a horse. It was so funny to me that he had to rent a horse. I mean, I guess, he would have a break, but I don't know if he'd be like familiar with how trains work. He's kind of just an astronomy nerd. Oh. That could have gone very badly. Let me eat some blackberries. Yeah, then he crashes the horse and kills it when he sees a Martian in the way. But not to worry, the guy he rented it from is also dead, so he didn't have to worry about that. Strange bun. Ooh. So cute. It's really funny because, like, the first couple of days, like, the Martians have arrived. Everyone's just kind of looking at them and nothing's happening. And then things start to go so wrong so fast. Listen, That horse was gonna die either way. The amount of destruction. These Martians are sparing nothing. No one. No one is surviving. There's actually, like, this imagery of, like, an entire valley. Well, not valley. I don't know why I'm saying valley, but, like, the entire area around him has just been burned to nothingness, with only, like, a railroad crossing and, like, a rare small shed surviving. Listen, you know, he definitely, you know, whipped the reins to the side when he crashed the horse and killed it, so, you know, part of, you know... You know. Sorry, I'm just also distracted because I'm also playing. Yeah, little guy. Love my little guy. Oh man, I hope my character doesn't pass out before I make it back to bed. That would suck. It'd be so embarrassing. How long have I been streaming? I'm not sure. Oh, 32 minutes. Okay, cool. I'm gonna put the strange bun in my this one because it's a little gifty for me. I also need to take that all over to Gunther. Oh, okay. Sorry, I'm going quiet here. I'm just. Pretty big brain at the moment. Is there anything? What do the geos look like? I keep forgetting. Nope, that's a frozen tier. I don't know what that is. I think the petrified slime can be used to make like slime forms, which I know is a thing. Question mark. Anyways, oh, I need to take a fire quart to Gunther, so I'm making that trip today. Nice. We finally found it after all these years. do. Something else to talk about. So I have to interview a family member for a, like, I have to do like a podcast interviewing a family member about education for one of my classes, and this was like scheduled to be like have something we do over Thanksgiving break, right, where everybody else is going home for Thanksgiving and seeing their relatives in person so they can like control things, like force their relatives to talk to them, you know, no escaping me now kind of thing. And when they can, you know, control the audio quality a little bit. Because we're supposed to make sure there's good audio quality. And I'm going to have to do mine over a call. And I know for a fact most of my family's mics suck. So that's like a major L there. But I'm pretty sure I won't get points off for something I can't control. And I'm definitely not making it across the country for Thanksgiving. I'm not even leaving my apartment for Thanksgiving. But yeah, I have to interview someone about education. And, you know, you'd think my mom, the substitute teacher, would be the one to ask. But I feel like her answers are going to be, like, charged. And, like, you know, it's going to be like she's going to have, like, a whole thing that she's going to want to talk about or something. I'm like, yeah, that's great. It's just not, like, a fun conversation to have at all, you know? Like, I love my mom, but I don't want to talk to her about, like, work. Stuff. I'm thinking about it's like Thursday of next week, and I'm thinking about doing a stream that day, just because a lot of my roommates are probably gonna be visiting relatives, so like I might be able to do something fun with like the whole apartment to myself, maybe like a baking stream or something. I want to make like apple pie. I love apple pie. I might just buy apple pie instead of making it though. I'm not sure how much effort I'm gonna feel like putting into it. Technically, I've never made pie crust before, which I've heard is, like, really difficult. But I might just, like, buy, like, a pre-made pie crust and then just make the filling. Because that's, from my understanding, like, the fun, easy part of making a pie. You know? And, you know, I don't want to do, like, the difficult part of making a pie. I want to do the fun, easy part. Oh, Welsh cakes? What are the, like, I don't think I've heard of that before. What is it? Other than, like, a cake, obviously. Like, what kind of cake is it? Dude, I've heard making pastry, though, is like, because pie crust is, like, a pastry thing. I've heard it's really difficult. Yeah. And I just don't know if I care about pie that much. But, like, if multiple people were like, yeah, if there's a baking stream, I'll turn out for it, then I would find it in my heart to try to figure out pastry and maybe, like, have a pre-made one as, like, a backup. Ooh, what are you? Something I'm gonna have to give to Gunther, probably. Look how many rocks I've given this man. This museum has never been better. Okay, after this night, I will pull that up and take a look at it. After, like, I finish this day. Oh, this is worth everything I've ever donated to the museum. I have won this. It's a giant bear. Plush. Well, that would give me, like, an idea, you know? And then I can maybe find, like, a better... Like, it would give me, like, a general idea of how hard it would be and whatever. And then I can work from there. Get something better to, like, find a better recipe or something. Huh. Cool. Bear. Shane, look. I got us a giant plush bear. I'm gonna move Junimo. I think it's Junimo. I don't know. I haven't paid enough attention. This is the place of honor. This thing's a nerd. It can go over here. I don't know. Hope that doesn't mess with Shane's pathfinding. I don't know how it works. Aw, thank you, Shane. Ooh, chocolate chips. I haven't had, like... I've been, like, way lighter on a chocolate than usual recently. Like, I've just been all in on fruit candies, but I think I could do with some, like, something chocolate, you know? Ooh, I got a yam. Yamite. You know. I don't know. I was about to try to quote Dr. Seuss. And then I totally lost it there. I'm pretty sure, like, Dr. Seuss, like, did something. Like he had, like, done something while he was alive. Like, been, like, it was, like, I don't know. I just remember, like, reading about it. Anyway. I don't know. I'm just saying anything that pops into my head today. Oh, I already had that. I didn't have to donate that to the museum. Nice. Well, imagine your Twitch app crashing. Couldn't be me. Never has been. Never will be. And it's not hubris fueling me to say that at all. I would never have hubris, ever. Actually. And if you see someone having hubris, it's not me. It's an imposter. I don't care about yams. I'm just gonna sell it. Go to bed if you're tired. I'm, like, tired too. I'm, like, probably gonna end stream in a couple minutes. I want to check out that recipe. This Saturday? Oh, wait, no. The thing is on Sunday. Right. I keep forgetting Jesus for Sunday. And I missed last week, which means I probably have to go to church this week. I don't know why I thought it was Saturday. Maybe. I My browser just did like an intro sound. I don't know why. Oh, I forgot to turn my thing on. Alright, it wasn't set yet, was it? Man, I have no idea what's going on ever. I don't know if I've seen caster sugar. Let me see what that is. The only thing I can think of that's finer than... So is it like halfway between... I think I can probably find... I think it might just be a different name for something. I'll have to look into that before I... Yeah, this should be pretty easy to make, though. Not sure how much a splash is meant to be, but, you know, I can work with that. Well, I think we just call it something different, because I'm pretty sure one of the... Because I clicked on a page about sugar, and it referred to powdered sugar as icing sugar. So I think just because it's like an English site, we just call it something different, and I don't remember that it was different, because I was like 6 when I moved here. So I didn't know much about the intricacies of sugar at the time. But I know we have powdered sugar, and we have regular sugar, and we have brown sugar. We have several types of sugar. So we probably do have caster sugar. It's probably just called something different. Let me actually look it up. Oh, yeah. It's probably here. Yeah, it's just gonna be called something different. And it's just halfway between regular sugar and powdered sugar. So worst comes to it, probably either one of those is not ideal, but would probably do. Anyway, I think I'm done for the night. You go back to that world, okay? And to anybody else watching, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And I hope to stream again soon if you'd like to see me stream. And, oh my gosh, everything's everywhere. Drop a follow, and I'm going to do a raid if you're sticking around. Because... OBS is telling me I have more than one person, which I think is enough to try to raid. Just because I am... no, I'm not gonna raid. I'm too tired. I'd have to, like, hunt somebody down, pick. And it's just, like, what, 2 people? Okay, yeah, and it's probably just because... So from what I can tell... Caster sugar is halfway between granulated and powdered, or icing sugar.